is Washington Akumu. I'm a communication consultant and a former business journalist. Initially, of course, there was no internet. Most journalists, especially the correspondents, used to send their stories over the phone. A journalist operating from Nyeri would ask for a reverse call. Then there were people in the newsroom called copy takers. So they were very fast typists. So they would type the story, and then, of course, it would go through the production process, the editing. It was all very manual. For instance, you literally had to send the plates to the printing press, physical plates for each page, because I started out in a newspaper. Having a mobile phone those days was like a status symbol. I remember, for instance, at the Nation newsroom, I can only remember three people who had mobile phones. One of them was my boss then, the other one was a sub-editor, and then there was a managing editor. So it was quite a novelty, and it was a preserve of the very rich in society. So it was a big story when Safaricom was launched, first as a department within Telkom, before it grew to become the giant it is today. For instance, I would be in a matatu and my phone would ring, and then everyone would turn around to look at me and treat me differently for the rest of the journey. I think Safaricom from the very outset got it right in terms of building a brand. Safaricom created both mental availability and physical availability, because sometimes brands are available in the mind, but you struggle to find them on ground. I think, first of all, congratulations. I think it's a great milestone. This is one of the toughest markets in Africa to build a brand and to build the kind of solid presence that Safaricom has built. Because Safaricom today is not just a company. It's so much integrated into what we are as a country. But on the whole, congratulations for a job well done.